בחינות הבגרות באנגלית, מועד חורף תשע"ו 2016, לתלמידים אינטרניים ואקסטרניים הנבחנים בשאלון ה', מודול E. שלום רב. היום אתם נבחנים בבחינות הבגרות בשפה האנגלית, ובעוד רגע ישודר הקטע בהבנת הנשמע. נשמיע לכם את הקטע הזה פעמיים. הודעה חשובה למשגיחי הבחינות ולנבחנים, אסור להקליט את הקטעים. יש להאזין לקטעים בשתי הקריאות שבשידור בלבד. בסיום השידור, על הנבחנים לשים את מקלטי הרדיו או כל מכשיר אחר בצידי החדר.
Hello, students. Today you are sitting for your Bagrut examination in English. In a moment, you will hear the text of your listening comprehension test, which will be read twice. And now, the first broadcast.
ועכשיו, השידור הראשון.
Hello, and welcome to Science in the News. In today's program, we will be talking to the psychologist, Dr. Leslie Turner, who does research on teenage behavior. Hello, Dr. Turner.
Hello, it's good to be here.
Dr. Turner, what is especially interesting to you about teenage behavior?
Well, we all know that teenagers often do things that are dangerous, and they can hurt themselves or others. For example, teenage drivers are involved in more traffic accidents than any other age group, and on average, they take more risks than adults do. For years, researchers have been studying teenage behavior to find out why teenagers often behave dangerously.
And what have they found?
Well, until recently, we psychologists thought we understood what makes teenagers behave the way they do. Some of us believed that kids don't actually recognize how dangerous their actions can be to themselves and to other people. Other psychologists thought that kids simply like the excitement of being in a dangerous situation and taking risks. They think of it as an adventure. But today, there are new research methods which show that these explanations are actually wrong.
What do you mean?
Well, in the past, we simply asked teenagers questions about their behavior, how they felt, why they did the dangerous things we see them do, or what they would do in a certain situation. In other words, the information we had about teenage behavior came from what teenagers themselves told us. But, of course, there can be a big difference between what people say they will do and what they actually do. So these days, we create situations in which teenagers have to make decisions, and we see what they choose to do. These experiments have provided much more reliable results.
Can you give us an example?
Certainly. In one recent experiment, a group of teenagers and a group of adults played a driving game on a computer screen. Several times during the game, the players had to decide whether or not to drive through a yellow traffic light. The researchers expected the teenagers to take the risk and drive through the yellow light more often than the adults did. However, that did not happen. The teenagers drove just as carefully as the adults. In the second part of the experiment, both groups were told that friends of theirs were sitting in another room watching them play. This information did not change the way the adults drove, but when the kids thought that their friends could see them playing, they took a lot more risks. Clearly, they were trying to make an impression on their friends.
Do scientists understand why the teenagers behaved this way?
Well, today we know that there are dramatic changes in the brain throughout a person's life. In teenagers, the most developed part of the brain is the part that is responsible for emotions. As we become adults, other areas of the brain develop more fully, especially the area that helps us think carefully before making decisions. Because that part of the brain is not well developed in teenagers, their decisions are easily influenced by emotions. And one very powerful emotion at this age is wanting to impress your friends.
Thank you, Dr. Turner. You've given us a lot to think about. This ends our program. Until next week, goodbye.
זה היה השידור הראשון. נשמיע עתה כמה צלילים, ואחר כך נשמיע את הקטע שנית. השידור השני.
Hello, and welcome to Science in the News. In today's program, we will be talking to the psychologist, Dr. Leslie Turner, who does research on teenage behavior. Hello, Dr. Turner.
Hello, it's good to be here.
Dr. Turner, what is especially interesting to you about teenage behavior?
Well, we all know that teenagers often do things that are dangerous, and they can hurt themselves or others. For example, teenage drivers are involved in more traffic accidents than any other age group, and on average, they take more risks than adults do. For years, researchers have been studying teenage behavior to find out why teenagers often behave dangerously.
And what have they found?
Well, until recently, we psychologists thought we understood what makes teenagers behave the way they do. Some of us believed that kids don't actually recognize how dangerous their actions can be to themselves and to other people. Other psychologists thought that kids simply like the excitement of being in a dangerous situation and taking risks. They think of it as an adventure. But today, there are new research methods which show that these explanations are actually wrong.
What do you mean?
Well, in the past, we simply asked teenagers questions about their behavior, how they felt, why they did the dangerous things we see them do, or what they would do in a certain situation. In other words, the information we had about teenage behavior came from what teenagers themselves told us. But, of course, there can be a big difference between what people say they will do and what they actually do. So these days, we create situations in which teenagers have to make decisions, and we see what they choose to do. These experiments have provided much more reliable results.
Can you give us an example?
Certainly. In one recent experiment, a group of teenagers and a group of adults played a driving game on a computer screen. Several times during the game, the players had to decide whether or not to drive through a yellow traffic light. The researchers expected the teenagers to take the risk and drive through the yellow light more often than the adults did. However, that did not happen. The teenagers drove just as carefully as the adults. In the second part of the experiment, both groups were told that friends of theirs were sitting in another room watching them play. This information did not change the way the adults drove, but when the kids thought that their friends could see them playing, they took a lot more risks. Clearly, they were trying to make an impression on their friends.
Do scientists understand why the teenagers behaved this way?
Well, today we know that there are dramatic changes in the brain throughout a person's life. In teenagers, the most developed part of the brain is the part that is responsible for emotions. As we become adults, other areas of the brain develop more fully. especially the area that helps us think carefully before making decisions. Because that part of the brain is not well developed in teenagers, their decisions are easily influenced by emotions. And one very powerful emotion at this age is wanting to impress your friends.
Thank you, Dr. Turner. You've given us a lot to think about. This ends our program. Until next week, goodbye.
זה היה השידור השני. אם לא סיימתם להשיב על השאלות, המשיכו לעשות זאת עכשיו, ואחר כך המשיכו בשאר חלקי הבחינה. משרד החינוך וכל ישראל מאחלים לכולכם הצלחה בבחינות הבגרות. שלום.